All right, so my name is Francesca Amiker from NBC 11 Alive with the A Scene. So thank you guys so much for speaking with us. Okay, who am I gonna start with? Tyler, as in the words of Dr. Phil, what in the hell were you thinking? This movie, you know, it's a Tyler Perry film, but then all of a sudden we get thrown with this like curveball. Yeah. Where did this come from?
Just, you know, in the writing, I'm just letting these characters speak to me. And at the time, there was a story that was pretty prevalent in the news that I was watching. And also, I was Gideon's Army about the public defender's state and office. And that whole thing showed up in the work for me. Yeah.
Phylicia, I have never seen you in the way that I saw you in this role.
Why she got such an attitude when she's talking to you?
Arms all folded,
like she's mad at you. She's a trained actress.
The film comes out today, and they don't know why. But I've never seen you with this much range, as much as we did. Even as a legend in your own right, do you feel that you are still pushed to a certain limit with this role? Were you still learning more things about yourself working with Mr. Perry?
I'm learning something every day, and the day I stop learning is the day I have to quit living.
That's exactly right.
What did you learn about yourself on this one?
I learned that I could be truthful in every moment, no matter what.
Yes. You certainly were. I said, oh, no, she didn't. No, Crystal, please tell me where you pulled from, because it was so, everything was so believable. You in that jail, you behind that man in that chair, everything. Where did you pull that from?
Girl, you know we know situations like that. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, we know things like that happen to women every day. But what I found out was when people saw the film, it happened to men too. The first person to tell me that was, what are y'all doing telling my story like that up there? That was amazing to me. So I just wanted to make sure I didn't miss the truth of the circumstances that happen to our women every other day and our men.
And you encapsulated it with such grace and beauty. And
thank you.
Just so dignified.
Thank you.
And I was so proud of you. I just feel like you are this standout star in film.
Thank you.
You are so believable as Jasmine. And, you know, looking at your character, I was curious to know, it took you 5 days to shoot this film.
Yes.
You were shooting with some legends.
Yes.
When you heard, okay, we got five days to shoot it, what were you thinking? What went through your head?
I just had to trust myself, and I had to bring it. I identified with Jasmine because she found fight within herself to trust her instincts and to go forward, even when everything was holding her back. And I, too, had that feeling as well, and I identified with that passion. I wept just at the opportunity to be on screen with Miss Cicely Tyson, with all these masters of the craft. I was just honored to be in the room at the table and to work amongst these amazing people.
Now I'm gonna get really, really honest for you, and this is for you, Tyler. You know, I treat you in my head like an uncle, someone I truly do respect, and someone who I do criticize your work, and this was one of your best movies ever. I truly enjoyed it. However, Tyler, you know, listening to this movie, there was a monologue in this film that truly hurt me to my core. It was when Macaud Brooks said, weak and old. And it was the way that he delivered that monologue that it hurt me. It hurt me so much.
And low-hanging fruit.
Low-hanging fruit.
Mm-hmm. Why?
It hurt me so much because it was almost as if you were revealing how so many black men talk to the black queens out there.
Yeah.
And it was almost as if that was our community secret. Showing people that. Mm-hmm. And so I wanted to ask you, why did you feel it was so important to put such a monologue in a film like that? Because just listening to it, I was insulted. Mm. I was proud because the acting was phenomenal, but I was insulted almost. Yeah.
Well, let me tell you, the things that my father said to my mother were far worse. And I was a child sitting there listening to it, trying to make her know that she was special, she was better than that. She didn't have to endure that. She didn't have to listen to that. I wanted to jump up and protect her, but I was too little and too young. So every time I'm writing these roles and I'm speaking to a woman, it doesn't matter if it's a woman of color, just a woman who is in this situation, what I'm trying to get her to do is have the reaction that you just had, being, I'm insulted by this and I'm hurt by this, so that I will never allow that to happen to me in my life. And it's on television, it's acting. I will never allow this moment to happen in front of my children. So if I can convey that to someone who feels, who's in this sort of position, then I've done exactly what I set out to do. Absolutely. And I know it's hard.
It hurt.
And
it really did hurt. It hurt.
But as far as the hurt goes, what you're showing me right now is something so deep and so personal for you. Mm-hmm. Like what I'm seeing right now is just something so deep and so personal for you. And my hope is that in that hurt, that you were able to recognize where that is coming from, what that is connected to, and how you feel, fix it, heal it within yourself.
I appreciate that. I really do.
And I appreciate your honesty.
I just said, I got to talk to him about this one monologue because it pissed me off so much that I wanted to leave the theater, but I commend your work. So I wanted to finish it through, mm-hmm. and I'm so glad I did because the movie was goddamn phenomenal. And then she took that back and moving on.
Yeah. But I really want you to connect with that to find out what that is in you because that's a place that needs something, some salve.
Thank
some
you.
Some soothing, some massaging.
Yes.
In your own soul.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. And my final question, of course, a fall from grace. Yeah. Was there ever a relationship that you all were in where you felt like you were falling from grace and you said, you know what, I can't do this anymore. It's over. And you may have felt those exact emotions that Grace felt.
Well, I have felt that, but I didn't feel like fighting back. I loved on purpose, but the circumstances were such that the Lord pulled me out.
Amen.
And the ha-ha is that this is what is the result.
Ain't it funny?
You too much. Congratulations
yes.
to each and every one of you. A phenomenal film. And Ryan, if you don't mind real quick, I know my time is over, so I'm just going to be quick with this. Tyler, just so you know, there was a story back in the day where you revealed that, you know, you helped a blind man cross the street.
Yeah.
Okay, you helped a blind man cross the street. And I just want you to know, when you came over to me during the grand opening of your movie theater, and you not only came over, but I said, Oprah to Oprah, and you brought her over there.
Yeah.
For the first time ever, you allowed my work to be seen on a national platform. Mm. That meant a lot. You helped me cross the street.
Yeah.
After that moment, I just wanted to do something for you on behalf of how I felt, how you mm-hmm. made me feel.
Mm-hmm.
Because you worked so hard, and to see that you saw me, it meant the world. So please accept this, and please look into it. Look at it.
Open the box, Tyler.
Open the box.
Open the box.
Real quick. I know Chantel's probably like, girl, if you don't, hurry it up. I just want you to open the box and just know that you provide so many opportunities.
Yes, you do.
Yep, for people to be seen.
Wow.
Yes, ma'am.
Wow.
Like myself.
Oh.
And it means the world. Oh, if I interview you, awesome. Never again, but thank you.
That's pretty powerful.
Mm-hmm.
Baby, who'd have thunk it? What my mother said to me. That's pretty awesome. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Baby, who would have thunk it? Thank you.
I'm so glad we started this way. I wasn't expecting this, thank you.
And don't forget the scripture at the top. That's the one that you said as you were homeless.
Oh, I didn't see that, yeah. Lord, I believe, help my unbelief. Yeah, Mark 9:20.
Thank you.
Yeah,
thank you. Each and every one of you for a beautiful film. Everyone's going to be talking about this tonight.
Thank you, beautiful.
Thank you. So beautiful.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Bring me a tissue.